Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. At 8:24 a.m. Central Daylight Time, or 6:24 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.7 earthquake near Bridgeport, California. This is close to the location where they had that magnitude 6.0. Close to Route 395, and that created some rock slides and damage and etc. That was on July 8th of this year. What we have is a volcanic arch, an ancient volcanic arch in this location. There used to be a lot of volcanism back in the day. Here you can see a location of 1, 2, and 3 volcanoes that I plotted out here. In the last 7 days, there's been 48 earthquakes of a magnitude 2.5 or greater. In all, for all earthquakes in the last week, 761. I've talked about the subduction of the Farallon Plate, how this is the southern edge of the Farallon Plate, that some scientists believe ended its subduction millions of years ago. Well, I don't agree with that. I think some of these ancient fault zones, these subduction zones, have been recently reactivated. Here you can see this whole area that's been reactivated, going all the way up to Lake Tahoe and that swarm that was going on up there. The Juan de Fuca fault zone, drawn out here in red, is a remnant of the Farallon Plate. And there was an earthquake, I reported that earlier today, of a magnitude 5.1. I found an article about the Bodie Hills and its interaction with the Farallon Plate and the subduction and different types of volcanism that occurred along here throughout the Sierra Nevadas. Yeah, going all the way up to Lake Tahoe, this arch. Yeah, lots of ancient volcanoes in this area. That's where a lot of the ski resorts are now built. Talked about the past tsunami that happened there at Lake Tahoe. Yeah, I got drawn out in yellow the different cinder cones, past volcanic eruptions. Using Google Earth and zooming into this location of this 3.7, you can see the lava flows here. Yeah, some of these ancient lava flows. Let me zoom in a little bit. See that? Now, this is also an area where the magma came up, but never actually broke through to the surface in a lot of areas. See that? There's more ancient lava flows right there. We have two things going on right now. We got a CME, a coronal mass ejection that came off the sun and is supposed to impact the Earth today or tomorrow. I haven't looked up today if it's impacting us, but that would also create earthquakes. And we also have the weakening of the Earth's magnetic field. The last time the Earth's magnetic field reversed, the continents actually moved. We had great earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, etc. So as the Earth's magnetic field weakens, we're going to see an increase in earthquakes and volcanic activity. And of course, it's going to affect our weather also. The moment tensor ball is really telling. The first wave of the earthquakes came straight up. Straight up from what I've been talking about, that magma chamber. It rose up. Tension was applied going east. You see here how the fault line rose up and we got spreading. Anywhere throughout this area, there is the capability of having a magnitude 7 or greater. Well, you already had a 6. And any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. 43 people took the time in reporting that they felt this earthquake. Reno up north, Roseville towards the west, and Los Banos, I believe that is, down south. Folsom Lake. Not far from here is Mono Lake and Mammoth Lakes. So the question is, did you feel this earthquake? How did your pets react before and after? How long did it last? What did the motion feel like? Please put all those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. You should be. Yeah, things are definitely happening around the world, aren't they? Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.